Operation Rosselsprung was a combined airborne and ground assault by the German 15th Mountain Corps and their allies on the Supreme Headquarters of the Yugoslav Partisans located in the Bosnian town of Drvar in the independent state of Croatia during World War II. The operation was launched on 25 May 1944, and was aimed at capturing or killing Marshal Josip Broz Tito and destroying the headquarters, support facilities and co-located Allied military missions. It is associated with the 7th enemy offensive in Yugoslav history. The airborne assault itself is also known as the Raid on Drvar. Operation Rosselsprung was a coup de main operation, involving direct action by a combined parachute and glider-borne assault by the 500th SS Parachute Battalion and a planned subsequent link-up with ground forces of the 15th Mountain Corps converging on Drvar. The airborne assault was preceded by heavy bombing of the town by the Luftwaffe. The ground forces included Home Guard forces of the independent state of Croatia, Tito, his principal headquarters staff and the Allied military personnel escaped, despite their presence in Drvar at the time of the airborne assault. The operation failed due to a number of factors, including partisan resistance in the town itself and along the approaches to Drvar, the failure of the various German intelligence agencies to share the limited intelligence available on Tito's exact location and the lack of contingency planning by the commander of the German airborne force also contributed to the unsuccessful outcome for the Germans. Background. The Axis Case White and Case Black offensives of the first 6 months of 1943 caused significant setbacks for the partisans. However, in September Tito took advantage of the capitulation of Italy and managed to increase the territory under his control and double his forces in size, to around 200,000 men, arming them with captured Italian weapons. In late November, he held a national congress at Jajce in the liberated area of northwestern Yugoslavia and designated himself marshal and prime minister. He established his headquarters nearby at Drvar in the Dinaric Alps and temporarily suspended his successful tactic of being constantly on the move. General Feldmarshal Maximilian von Weichs, the Wehrmacht commander-in-chief Southeast Europe, admitted a few weeks later that Tito is our most dangerous enemy. Drvar was located within the territory of the German puppet state, the independent state of Croatia. Tito's personal headquarters was initially located in a cave about 1 kilometer north of the center of Drvar. The UNAC River ran along the base of the ridgeline above the cave, creating an obstacle to movement between the town and the cave, and a rail line ran along the ridgeline behind the cave. In addition to partisan headquarters, various partisan and Communist Party of Yugoslavia support, training and youth organizations were also based in and around Drvar at the time, along with the Tito Escort Battalion, which was responsible for his personal safety. The British and Soviet military missions to the partisans were also stationed in villages close to Drvar, as were some United States military officers on various missions. The British mission was headed by Brigadier Fitzroy MacLean, who was in London at the time of the raid, and included Major Randolph Churchill, son of Winston Churchill. At the time of Operation Rosselsprung, the British mission was led by its second-in-command, Lieutenant Colonel Vivian Street. Partisan dispositions around Drvar. Apart from partisan headquarters and related organizations close in and around Drvar, there were between 12,000 and 16,000 partisans in the area of operations that would be subject to the ground assault by 15th Mountain Corps. In the immediate vicinity of Drvar was the 1st Proletarian Corps commanded by Kocka Popovich, which consisted of the elite 1st Proletarian and 6th Lika Proletarian divisions, with the corps headquarters located in the village of Mokronogi, 6 kilometers east of Drvar. The 6th Lika Proletarian Division was west of Drvar, and the 1st Proletarian Division was deployed in the area around Jajce and Mr Konjic Grad. some 50 kilometers east of Drivar. The nearest large partisan formation to Drivar was the 3rd Leica Proletarian Brigade of the 6th Leica Proletarian Division based in the Rysanovchian Truba villages some 10 kilometers south and southwest of Drivar. In the wider area of operations were the Partisan 5th Corps commanded by Slavko Rodik and 8th Corps commanded by Vlado Setkovich. The 5th Corps was deployed to the northeast and northwest of Drivar with its headquarters south of the Mr. Konichgrad KLJUC road, and the 8th Corps was positioned to the southeast with its headquarters in the mountains between the Glamik and Livna valleys. Importantly for the coming battle, the 4th Krajina Division of the 5th Corps was deployed between Bihac and Bosansky Petrovac. Two brigades of the 4th Krajina Division and one brigade from the 39th Krajina Division formed a defensive arc north of Drivar, running from Bihac through Krupa to Sanski Most. The 9th Dalmatian Division of the 8th Corps was deployed to the south between Livno and Bosansko Grahovo. German intelligence. Three organizations attempted to determine the location of Tito's headquarters and the disposition of partisan forces in Drivar. The first of these was the Benesh Special Unit of Section 2 of the Abwehr, some members of which had been involved in identifying Tito's presence in the town of Jajce prior to the German offensive to retake the town. The Benesh Special Unit was part of the Brandenburg Division, and was staffed by ethnic Germans who spoke local languages. The unit had many contacts with both the Chetniks and Astes militia, and had been tracking Tito since October 1943. Lieutenant Kirchner of that unit had been responsible for locating Tito prior to the recapture of Jajce, and he established a patrol base near Bosansko Grahovo. He got very close to the Drivar cave, and located the Allied military missions. But despite German radio intercepts confirming that Drivar was the site of Tito's headquarters, Kirchner was unable to pinpoint the cave as the location of the headquarters. Kirchner was attached to the 500th SS Parachute Battalion for the operation. The second intelligence organization was FAT 216 of Section I of the Abwehr, FAT 216, commanded by Lieutenant Zavadl, was also attached to the 500th SS Parachute Battalion, but did not contribute much to the intelligence used to plan the raid. On Hitler's orders, SS Sturmbannführer Otto Skorzeny of the Sicherheitsdienst, who had commanded the operation to rescue Mussolini in September 1943, was independently involved in intelligence gathering in the lead up to the raid. Skorzeny acted on behalf of the SD, and after obtaining information from a partisan deserter that pinpointed Tito's headquarters at the cave, he proposed a plan to infiltrate Drivar with a small group of soldiers to assassinate Tito. Skorzeny soon discovered that the plan to eliminate Tito had been compromised, and had nothing further to do with the operation. It appears that he did not pass on the useful intelligence he had gathered to SS Hauptsturmfuhrer Kurt Reibke, the commander of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion, who was responsible for planning the critical airborne aspects of the operation. Largely due to inter-service rivalry and competition, the three organizations did not share the intelligence they gathered, which had a significant effect on the tactical planning and execution of the operation. Partisan intelligence. The partisans had their own highly effective intelligence network. They had been aware of the presence of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion in Yugoslavia for some time, and had been aware of the general threat of an airborne assault for over 6 months. They may have become aware of the isolation of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion or the concentration of transport aircraft and gliders at Zagreb and Banja Luka over a month before the operation. The partisans also managed to recapture the deserter Skorzeny had interrogated. As a result of these early indicators of an attack, Tito's main headquarters was relocated to another cave near the village of Bastasi, 7 kilometers west of Drivar. Tito then used the Drivar cave during the day, but returned to the Bastasi cave at night. In addition to this precaution, elements of the 6th Leica Proletarian Division were moved closer to Drivar. On 23 May 1944, a single German Fieslerfy 156 reconnaissance aircraft flew a number of parallel runs up and down the Unna Valley over Drivar at around 600 meters, activity consistent with conducting aerial photography. The aircraft paid particular attention to the villages of Prinovor and Treninic Brijeg, where the British military mission and American military personnel were located. This was observed by Street, the acting commander of the British military mission, who assumed it was spotting for a bombing raid and advised both Tito and the Americans. Both Allied missions moved their locations as a result. Despite the intelligence received and observations made by the British, the partisans appear to have been quite complacent about the threat, with Tito's chief of staff, Arso Jovanovich, swearing that a German attack was impossible. The most obvious indicator that Tito was unaware of the imminent attack is that he remained at the Drivar cave overnight on the evening of 24 May, 1944. Following his birthday celebrations, instead of returning to Bas to see, through Ultra intercepts a German signal traffic, the British had become aware that the Germans were planning an operation codenamed Rosselsprung, but the information available did not include where the operation would occur or what its objectives might be. Planning. Following intelligence collection, higher-level planning for the operation began on 6 May 1944, after von Weichs had issued his orders. Hitler gave his approval to von Weichs' final plans on 21 May. The order to 15th Mountain Corps was issued by General Oberst Lothar Rundulich, the commander of 2nd Panzer Army, on the same day, leaving only 3 days for preparation. General der Infanterie Ernst von Laeser, commander of 15th Mountain Corps headquartered at Nin, was responsible for the conduct of the operation. The ground forces of von Laeser's 15th Mountain Corps were significantly reinforced from Army Group F, the 2nd Panzer Army and 5th SS Mountain Corps reserves. These reinforcements included two panzer companies, the reconnaissance battalions of the 1st Mountain Division and the 369th Infantry Division, and most of 7th SS Volunteer Mountain Division Prinz Eugen. In outline, the 15th Mountain Corps plan was for a heavy aerial bombardment of partisan positions in and around Drivar by Luftwaffe aircraft, followed by a parachute and glider assault by the 500th SS Parachute Battalion, who had the task of capturing or killing Tito and destroying his headquarters. The assault also included tasks to capture or destroy the Allied military missions to the partisans. On the same day, ground elements of 15th Mountain Corps were to converge on Drivar to link up with the 500th SS Parachute Battalion. A small reconnaissance aircraft was tasked to fly into Drivar after its capture to retrieve Tito or his body. 500th SS Parachute Battalion Rybka received an outline of the operation on 20 May, and more details the following day. He realized that the gliders and transport aircraft would be insufficient for the whole of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion to be delivered to Drivar in one lift, so he came up with a plan involving two waves. The first wave of 654 troops would conduct the assault at 700 and a second wave of 220 troops would follow about 5 hours later. Critically, the intelligence he was given regarding the suspected location of Tito's headquarters was that it was in or near a cemetery on high ground southwest of the center of Drivar, nearly 2 kilometers from Tito's actual headquarters cave. This would have far-reaching effects on the planning and execution of the assault. Rybka's plan for the first wave called for the insertion of 314 parachute troops in three groups to secure the town, and another 354 troops in 6 glider-borne assault groups to carry out specific tasks. The glider-borne group tasks were Panther Group, capture Citadel and destroy Tito's headquarters, to land at the cemetery, Greifer Group, destroy the British military mission in the village of Pranyevor, 2 kilometers south of Drivar on the road to Bosansko Grahovo. Sturma Group, destroy the Soviet military mission between the center of Drivar and the UNAC River. Brekker Group, destroy the American military mission in the village of Trninik Brijeg, 2 kilometers south of the center of Drivar. Draufganger Group, capture the crossroads immediately to the west of Drivar, including a nearby suspected communications facility. Biasa Group, seize an outpost radio station to the south of Pranyevor, then assist the Greifer Group. The second wave of 220 troops based on the training company of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion were to insert by parachute at midday. Rybka does not appear to have planned for any significant contingencies, such as errors in the intelligence on the location of Tito's headquarters. His only contingency plan was that he would fire a red signal flare to order all available forces to converge on his position for subsequent tasks. On the 22nd of May 1944, the 500th SS Parachute Battalion were transported to airfield at Nagy Betskarek, Zagreb and Banja Luka, dressed in Wehrmacht uniforms for security reasons. However, the troops were not briefed on the operation until a few hours before it was launched. They then linked up with their transport aircraft, including the 10-man gliders that would deliver the glider-borne troops onto their objectives. By the 24th of May, all preparations for the airborne assault were complete. Ground forces. The plan for the ground forces of Onlaze's 15th Mountain Corps was for 9 separate but coordinated thrusts toward the Drivar-Bosansky Petrovac area from all directions. The groupings and tasks were the 384th Infantry Regiment of the 373rd Infantry Division, with elements of the 2nd Company of the 202nd Panzer Battalion, referred to as Kampfgruppe Wilhelm after its commander, Oberst Wilhelm, was to advance east at 500 from the village of SRB toward Drivar. Kampfgruppe Wilhelm had the primary responsibility for relieving then taking command of the 500th SS Parachute Battalion in Drivar on the 25th of May, and was then to attack in the direction of Bosansky Petrovac. A battalion group of the 373rd Infantry Division was to set out at 500 from Lopak and drive east through Kulinvakuf to capture the crossroads at VRTOCE. If necessary, they were then to advance northwest toward Bihak to open the road. The 92nd Motorized Regiment, with the 54th Reconnaissance Battalion, the 55th Pioneer Battalion, the 468th Armored Car Company, and a regimental group of the 2nd Croatian Light Infantry Brigade was to advance southeast from Bihak and Bosanska Krupa at 500 through the village of VRTOCE to capture Bosanski Petrovac as quickly as possible, destroy the partisans in that location, and occupy the partisan airfield and supply installations. After capturing Bosanski Petrovac, elements were to be sent toward Drivar to prevent the withdrawal of partisans along that road and to link up with the 500th SS Parachute Battalion in Drivar. A regimental group of the 7th SS Division was to advance west from the area of Mr. Konichgrad, break through partisan resistance east of the Sana and then advance on a wide front to block escape routes east out of Drivar. Part of this group was to advance from Jajsa along the rail line and roads through Savasi to reach their objective, the area around Mlinister power station. An ad hoc Kampfgruppe Panzergrenadier Sturm Battalion manned by officer cadets, with 1st Company of the 202nd Panzer Battalion, under the command of the 7th SS Division, was to advance from Banja Luka toward Kljuc to seize the crossing point across the Sana utilized by the partisans. The 105th SS Reconnaissance Battalion with an additional panzer company was to advance from Livna and occupy any partisan supply installations in the Livna Valley. and prevent any partisan withdrawal to the south of Drivar by attacking through Bosansky Grahovo toward Drivar. The 369th Reconnaissance Battalion of the 369th Infantry Division, under the command of the 105th SS Reconnaissance Battalion, were to advance from Livna up the Glamic Valley against partisan forces withdrawing from Drivar to the southeast. The 1st Regiment of the Brandenburg Division, along with the Chetnik Dinara Division, were to advance from Nin toward Bosansky Grahovo and conduct special operations against partisans in the Prekarja Drivar area.